Olá, novos e seminovos, velhos e semivelhos, eu sou o Eric Risato e este é o canal Som do Cassete. No vídeo de hoje você vai conferir uma entrevista exclusiva com Kimberly Wetmore, vocalista do grupo Out of Control, que teve sucessos como Sinful Wishes, One of Us e vários outros. Mas antes, deixa seu like, se inscreva no canal e não se esqueça de acionar a legenda para não perder nenhum detalhe dessa super entrevista. Bora lá?
O Som do Cassete.
How you doing, my dear?
You know what? I'm making the best of it. I'm doing okay.
And you started your career when you was a child, or when it come? When
it come to you? Music? I was very young. Very young. I was 12 years old, and I was in theater. So I started dancing, singing, and acting.
Good.
Going to a lot of auditions.
Good. And when came to you the invite to join in the Out of Control?
Well, I was recommended to Barry Harris.
Barry Harris.
Barry Harris, yes, of Con Can.
I gave it all to you, my destiny.
The legendary.
Yes, that's right. So I was working with friends of Barry, and Barry had said, hey, I'm looking for a new singer. And they said, oh, you know, you should meet this Kimberly Wetmore. And he'd never heard of me.
Never.
And his friends were like, no, you try. And we met, we recorded, and we just clicked instantly.
You work in the third album from Con Can, right?
Yes.
You the backing vocal from Sinful Wishes, the first version, right? You was
no,
there.
No, I didn't do the, no, that was Simone Denny, I think it was.
Ah, good.
That was Simone Denny. I did a lot of other projects with Barry as well. After we did Out of Control, I did a lot. Filter Queen, I did a lot of vocals for Barry in different projects he did. So
you're still in contact. You're still in contact with him. He already came in my city.
Yeah.
In the night,
so
the 80s.
From? So where
I'm from Divinópolis. He came here when he was working with Con Can.
Okay, yeah.
Your first official record that used your voice like a group, not only like a backing vocal, was Out of Control. Or there's something hyped behind.
Yes, my first record. I had sung a lot of different material, but not an entire record or CD. I actually started singing country.
Country? Shania Twain from your...
Yes, and it's not because I wanted to. It was because someone said, oh, you should sing this song. And by the way, it's country. And I was like, oh.
Country is strong in Canada.
It is. It's and it's, you know what, actually country has exploded all over. Country music has now become more pop than anything. So, you know, here's to all the artists. If there's more talent out there, I think that's fantastic. It just at the time wasn't really what I wanted to do. So when I got a chance to sing with Barry and with Rashid, it was just so much fun because it was more along the lines of the music that I wanted to do at the time.
The tracks already done, do you work with the boys, with the lyrics, with the picking music to enter in the CD or not? You just lend your voice and start to make part from Out of Control. How it happened?
At that time, it was just my voice I had to offer. I was young, much younger. And at that time, I wasn't sure, as much as I loved doing the dance music, I wasn't sure who I wanted to be as an artist. So when I first met them, it was just supposed to be one song and just a job, just another studio job. Because at the time, I did a lot of studio work. So it wasn't supposed to be a whole album. And that's why I just lent my voice. And then he kept calling me back and hiring me for more. And then he said, oh, by the way, you know, we really love your music and we've sold it and it's number one in Brazil. And now we're going to do a whole CD. And I was like, what?
The first record, the first single was?
If God Were One of Us. And then Sinful Wishes. Yeah.
Was a huge success. I believe not only in Brazil, a lot of countries, especially USA too.
It was a lot of fun.
And the video is perfect. It's a masterpiece. Where was shoot that video that
I'm
you
glad
was?
You think so?
Golden Girl.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I remember we were filming in New York City and it was the weekend of the Super Bowl. So I felt so bad because we're filming in this big studio in New York City and all of the gentlemen there wanted to be watching the football game. And I felt so bad. I was like, oh, I'm so sorry, you know, but it was fun. Yes, I got to sit on, because I was spinning around in the video. I got to sit on a, you can't see it, but I'm sitting on a record player so that I can spin around.
Like a vinyl.
Yeah.
The second one was Sinful Wishes. But I don't Sinful Wishes. Was released before with yep. Paris in Conquer. Yes. You already know this track, how it happened, the process of Sinful Wishes. It was the second one, right?
Yes, it was the second one, yes. Well, like I said, Barry and I started to really work well together in the studio. And Barry suggested that we do a remake of that song because that was one of his favorite songs. And he felt that I would be able to offer something to it. So it's funny that you mentioned that because I spoke with Barry not long ago, maybe, well, everything seems a long time now since the beginning of COVID, but I spoke to him right around the beginning of COVID, so maybe March, specifically about us doing an online sort of version of Sinful Wishes. And we were having fun, and then it became a little crazy. So we said, you know what, we'll come back to it. But we were talking about doing it because we just hit home for both of us, the fun we had, we clicked musically. So that's how it came about. So it was Barry's idea because it was one of his favorite songs.
Made more success than the first release because was released, Sinful Wish, only in Canada or make success yes. only in Canada. And when Sinful Wish came again with your voice, was a huge success, I think, not only in Brazil, but when you came to Brazil?
We came as the group Out of Control. Yes. And it's funny because I still have one of my favorite pictures, group pictures. I don't know if you can see up in my office up there.
Good.
With
yes.
Barry, Rashid, and I. That's one of my favorite pictures.
After show.
That was at a show, yeah. And I just love it because we're just having so much fun. So Brazil, how it all happened, like I said, Barry, it was Barry's music, and Rashid came in and made it more modern and added his own flair. Rashid did a lot of programming and he played keyboards as well. So, in fact, I was thinking of Brazil the other day, and because I wondered, whatever happened to Guaraná? That was the drink. That was the drink there, and that's all I remember is like, Guaraná!
And was the first time that you came to Brazil? You visit yes. South America.
That was the very first time I'd been to Brazil, and it was with Out of Control. So I believe we started, and this was a long time ago, I believe we started in, oh my goodness, I just had it in the tip of my tongue. Okay, so we were in, oh my gosh, I just forgot.
Araraquara.
Do you remember
the name?
Araraquara. Yes.
So difficult, so hard to fix.
That was the first place. And I just remember looking around being like, wow, oh my gosh, this is so beautiful. This is so raw, so stunning.
Do you stay in Brazil doing concert for how long?
Just over 3 weeks.
Only three weeks?
Yeah.
Do you remember how many shows? Do you remember how many shows?
Oh gosh, no. I don't remember how many. I remember some of the names, like Xuxa show and...
How is you?
Yes, yes, yes.
You are so smart. Oh, you know.
And but, I remember splitting my outfit on TV.
Yes. Do you try the food, try the drinks, meet people? Do you have contact with somebody that used to work in that time?
Well, the cool thing was the record label over there sent us, you know, a manager that went with us and acted as an interpreter and a manager. And she was fantastic because she took us to favorite restaurants. She, you know, here, you want to meet these people. These are nice people. And it wasn't just all business for her. So she taught us a lot about the culture at the time in Brazil. And of course, I'm still trying to remember the other place in the country. And it was more of a farming region at the time.
Manaus.
Pardon me?
Amazonas, Manaus,
No, São it was Paulo. Something to something. No, we were in Sao Paulo for sure, but something to something. Sao Paulo was here and it was up north.
Bahia, Rio de Janeiro, Amazonas, Manaus. Desculpa.
You watch, I'll remember later and I'll be like, oh.
But, good. And you have a chance to do a job, lend your voice for a project in here, right? Do you remember this track?
Yes, it was something about love in the sea. I can't remember the name of it though. I remember.
Hola. Do you remember Hola?
Hola, was that it? I remember recording and singing Spanish and Brazilian Portuguese.
Yes. Yeah. And you came to do this job or it happened here in Brazil?
Oh, I did
came
it
here.
There.
Let's record this track.
I did it in Brazil.
And you was a parallel project from Conca.
Yes, it was totally separate.
Auto control.
And it was totally separate and it was a lot of fun. I only hope that I did it justice with the pronunciation. Because, you know, it was a challenge.
Do you have your own collection?
I do.
From your release?
I have other music. But you know what? It's funny. I was always one of those people that I just wanted to sing. Like people want to dance. I didn't want to be a star so much as I just wanted to make people happy by singing. So it didn't matter to me if I was singing something that I wrote or something that somebody else wrote. If I saw you in the audience and I knew or I felt that I could put a smile on your face by singing, that's all I wanted to do.
Good.
So I've done a lot of work on other people's music. I've recorded a lot in the studio. I've toured with other artists doing backups. Now that I'm a little older.
Older?
And I enjoyed it.
You're youngest than 90s. After Sinfoishi came the third single. Right?
Together in Electric Dreams.
We'll always be together, however far it seems.
Do you have contact with Marauder?
No, I don't. I did at one point, and then simply because I wasn't going back and forth to LA anymore, I just lost contact. I started doing a lot more work here in Canada, doing a lot more studio work and session work. So I was just focused on what I was doing at the time.
Yes. And in the first album, the album has a Marauder feeling. There's a Marauder finger.
Yes, it does.
Do you have this album?
I have the CDs. I have a few, yes. And from, I have a box, a Rubbermaid box. My cat is actually sleeping on it now, of memorabilia from all the wonderful places I traveled, not just Brazil, but all the other places I traveled. I bought maps and I circled them and little pieces from the countries, you know. So I have the CDs, yeah.
A box of out of control.
Yeah, I just, you know, because it's a wonderful memory, a part of your past that you can go, hey, and like I said, I have my favorite picture that I keep up there. And, you know, when I got to wear purple skin tight PVC outfits.
And your outfits is inside this box too?
Yep, actually, I can still wear them. I'm proud of that.
Yes, you can.
They're over, what, 20?
20,
yeah, they're 20, 25 years old.
26, 25, 25, yes. This year, 26. Yeah. But something like that. And yes, you can wear your outfit.
Well, I can fit into them. I don't know if I'd wear them out.
Yes, and we can see you again with this outfit and on stage with Barry and the other guy, I forget the name.
Rashid.
Yes, Rashid.
Yes.
We call it Rashid. Rashid.
Yeah.
And there's something come in the future. Do you still speak about doing something together or not?
Yeah, we do.
Was a different style. Yep, you don't want to repeat anymore.
We've actually talked about it, like I said, because Barry and I were talking again about doing a lot more recordings, because we kind of felt, wouldn't it be cool to do a 25-year reunion?
Oh, good.
Well, you know?
There's a lot
and
of fans.
COVID hit.
Do you know how many fans you have here? How much Brazilian love you and Out of Control, and especially Barry. Barry is more than Out of Control, because he works in...
Barry is, he's CanCon. Or ConCan.
ConCan and Thunder Press, too.
Yes, I did a lot of work on the Thunderpuss album too.
You work too?
Yeah.
Yeah, like a
singer,
backing
vocals. On
vocalist.
That. Yeah.
There's a track that we can look for.
I used a lot of pseudonyms with Barry, so I would do tracks for him under names like Energy Girl.
Yes, Energy Girl.
You know, like NRG.
Yes, Energy.
And,
yes,
imagine, because he didn't want them to know it was a lot of me. So he had me use secret names on his tracks.
And it used to work a lot in the past. We can point a lot of singer that used to do this job.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But you, after Out of Control, you keep work on this area, on this style, dance music, right? Or well, you jump to
I actually
clubs.
Jumped. I jumped to something else. I came back and I started doing other work, because at the time, that's what people asked me to do. And then a Canadian label asked me to re-release Out of Control. But at the time, I was working on other music. I was doing more singer-songwriter, and I was still sort of discovering who I was. And
yes.
Then I started just doing different work. It was sort of like, wow, I've done that. Now I want to try this. I want to stretch my voice a bit. I want to try singing a little bit of that.
You're born and raised in Canada.
Yes.
Right?
The land of no accent.
Good. And we consume a lot of Canadian artists, especially in the 90s, because there's Bryan Adams,
yeah,
Shania Celine
Twain,
Joel,
yeah,
Shania Twain, and for me, one is special, Alanis Morissette.
Oh, wow, cool.
My daughter calls Alanis.
Yeah.
Inspired by the name. Do you work with the scene? Do you have contact with Alanis or the other singers or not?
Well, Alanis moved out closer. to Alanis moved out to the States. I don't remember where she is now. I had contact with a lot of like Kim Esty. You remember Kim Esty and all those dance artists? And I did a few shows with, oh my gosh, this we're getting old. I'm forgetting names. but other dance artists. But when I started to change styles, I started to work more with Canadian, almost rock, but pop rock.
Pop rock.
Sass Jordan, things like that. So I started touring with and working with those artists. Even, you know, even some older artists like 80s bands like Hollywoods and Toronto, you know, like I started working with and touring with those artists.
Are you living in?
I live in, yes, I live just outside of Toronto. I live in Hamilton, which is a very large city just outside of Toronto.
Hamilton,
yes. Ontario. Yeah.
Now, what are you doing now? What style do you dance? Okay, what style do you sing?
Well, I definitely, as I matured as a singer, because I sang so many other people's songs for a long time, I developed my own style. Now, I can describe my style, but I would say people describe it as a sort of soulful, I don't want to say raunchy, but because I have a lot of power still, a soulful, funky sound. This is not so good to describe it. I'm not describing it very well. But I have to sing songs that have meaning to me. I mean, I love dance music, but it's got to have a little bit of soul. It has to come from the heart.
Good.
So my style is a little more funky, like a Dua Lipa energy, but with the funk of a Joss Stone. You can boogie now. There's no time to waste. Let's get the show on the road. I have a job. Because of COVID, I have a day job.
Change everything.
Yeah, it does. But I was, yeah, I did my last show March 15th last year. And then I did another show in August. But that's it. And I was singing, you know, 4 and 5 days a week up until then. It was everything, kind of like I said, from funk to rock to pop to dance. I keep a busy schedule here, everything from corporate, like the Brazilian, there was a big mining and the Brazilian consul had a party here and we, you know, my band performs at that party.
Oh, good.
So things like that.
Yes, it's a Brazilian day, I think, something like that. I don't know.
Yeah. So, those are the things that I was staying busy singing with my band, and we would perform at those sort of private corporate functions and things like that. And weddings.
I visit your website, was so updated. There's a lot of information. I can book you. It's a good thing to know. There's a lot of project, other project. And I really want to know if, do you want to try some one more time to go to the state to do something like you used to do in 90 that is different you're doing now?
Yes, I would love to go back. And I've said this to Barry, because when I first recorded the songs, I, as much as I loved hearing them, I was still young. And it was kind of like when you came on and someone said, okay, here's how you're going to interview. You're going to do this, this, and this. And you went, okay. And that's what I did in the studio. And now that you're more mature, you've developed your own style, your own approach, and you know that you still have to do A, B, and C, but you're going to go, here's A, but then I'm going to throw in a bit of C because I think that that's what's needed right here. So I would love to go back and do those songs live with a little bit of my own little personal flavor. And as you can tell with me with purple hair, I have a lot of flavor. So I would love to do that.
This is the first time since 90s that you give in an interview to your Brazilian fans. And you can see it in the social media, on your website, on Facebook, that Brazil is following you, Brazil is looking for you. Do you feel
I'm
it?
Always surprised, though. I'm always surprised because I'm very grateful, but I'm always surprised. I'm like, oh wow, you remember that? So it's very flattering, but I don't think of it, I guess, because I'm very grateful for the experience, but I try in life to focus on the here and the now. So I loved that I had the opportunity to meet so many wonderful people and have an effect that made them happy. And oh my gosh, the country is beautiful. And I've always wanted to go back.
Good. We're waiting
but
for
I,
you.
I don't want to have regrets. So I just try to go, okay, well, I can't do that now because of COVID. So I'm going to focus on what I can do. I'm going to focus on now.
Maybe after COVID,
maybe then we can all travel.
we can, you can return, you can sing to us. And you are present in a lot of TV program, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And you did a lot of show concert.
Yes.
And your set list was based only on Concan, or there's other thing? There's Liberty from Concan or Madonna, something like that, or not? It's just Concan set list that time.
At that time, it was mostly Concan stuff.
Good.
Yeah. Good.
And let's return to the question. Dark Side Joe, my friend, that is made it this interview came true. John Osborne was canceled, suffered a lot. It's a music that talk about God, talk about Jesus, something like that.
Yes.
A boycott with out of control happened too or not?
Not that I'm aware of, no. No, we didn't really, over here, Canada, North America is very, very relaxed in the sense that, although maybe not now, but at the time, it was very relaxed. And I always found it interesting that when I was in Brazil, everyone was so open about a lot of things. And then, you know, I didn't realize that religion could be such a sensitive topic.
Yes.
Because here it wasn't at the time. So we didn't really run into any issues with that at the time here.
Yes, good. The time, everything changed. Fabio Alan, do you sing Take Me to Home Tonight?
Yes.
From Imagine
Take
Project.
Take me home tonight. Yeah.
Yes, was a huge success too. Imagine was you work with Harris too?
Yes. And Barry, or rather, Hashid, as you say. Yeah. Imagine, I can't remember if it was just Barry or if it was also Rashid, but yes. Yeah, I was Imagine, Ecstasy, Energy Girl.
It's not only out of control to work. It's a good, there's a lot of, there's a beside lost behind from out of control, this project that was not released.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if it will, because sometimes you'll do projects and the producer says, that's it. I don't want to do it. And they hide them away. When I was doing those projects, they weren't part of Out of Control. So again, I was just being paid as the singer. So I came in and it was, you do this. I say, yes, sir. And the producer decides.
Only one time.
Yes.
To record now, and not receive the right.
Correct. So I would come in and I would only get paid to do the singing. And then sometimes the producer would use it, sometimes not. So Barry probably has a whole bunch of stuff. Other producers I've worked with, you know, the Boomtang Boys, the Stick Men, the Orange Men.
Orange Men, your work was released.
I don't, I don't know, actually. I don't remember.
We will look for. Do you have a special place that you want to visit again? Something that is inside your heart that you really want to return in Brazil?
I do. And I'm trying to remember the darn name of the place. I want to scooch, tell my cat to get off my memory box and go digging in it.
Do you remember
we were at the beach. We were at the beach. But I think Sao Paulo is obviously just, it's so, okay, from my perspective, Sao Paulo has more people in one city than Canada. I mean, so to me, Sao Paulo is just like a giant playground of people and things to see and to do and the markets and so much to explore. You know, I mean, it's like I said, there's more people in that city than in my entire country. Sao Paulo, but also the place up north where it's mostly farmland. But now it's like a farmland artist commune. Oh, my goodness.
Ceará, Fortaleza, Piauí, deixa eu ver, Belém do Pará, Natal, Bahia, Salvador. Is on the coast?
No, it's inland. It's inland.
Maranhão.
No, it's not Rio. I mean, Rio is stunning. Oh my gosh, there's so many beautiful people there. I think all of us, the boys and I, were just like, wow.
It's a different
biotic. And seeing the Corpus Christi, and I mean, there's so many beautiful things to see there.
You have a lot of fun. You visit a lot of country. You make some
Belo
money.
Belo Horizonte.
Huh?
Belo Horizonte.
Belo Horizonte? Sério?
Yes, thank you. Belo Horizonte.
Você gostou? What do you like in that city?
What did I like there? It just seemed, because it was so busy for us when we were on tour, and Sao Paulo was like New York. It was just so on fire and exciting. So that when we went there, it was like,
oh, relax.
I could appreciate nature and just kind of, and it gave me a little more time. It didn't seem as hurried.
Big so mountains.
I love mountains. I love the mountains.
Good. It's near from my city.
Oh,
it's,
yeah?
It's 1 hour from here, from my house.
See, I really enjoyed Belo Horizonte.
Yes, Belo Horizonte.
Belo Horizonte.
Yeah, your Portuguese is perfect.
I'm remembering a few things like a próxima música, eh?
Good. And the food.
Oh my gosh, the food. I ate so much of it. Thank heavens I was dancing all night, every night. Food, I like food. Food is good.
Food is very good.
And the coffee.
Hot food and spice.
Yeah.
And different. I think it's a little bit different from Canada.
Oh, definitely.
It's more, it's colder than here. And
well, I remember now one of our favorite restaurants here in Niagara Falls is Churrascario?
Churrascaria.
Oh my goodness, my pronunciation is awful. Churrascaria.
Churrascaria, that's perfect. Churrascaria.
You're being nice to me.
in this barbecue there.
Yes. So we go there and my boyfriend's like, oh, look at the dancers, like Brazilian dancers. I'm like, that's nothing. You should see the real dancers.
Yeah, that's good. But next time you came to Brazil, you bring your boyfriend and bring your joy, your smile, your voice, your different hair. Beautiful hair. Beautiful hair. I think you're stunning. And you're younger than that time.
You can just see my face now.
But you change for better.
Oh, thank you, very much.
You know. And you are in our hearts. There's a lot of thing to do, especially sing. And you can sing to us.
Sure.
Can you sing two successes, or if you want to sing three, sing for Wishes, One of Us, you can sing for us a little bit.
Let's say, I should have warmed up.
You remember?
I go to bed with sinful wishes, and I go to sleep with sinful wishes of you. I'm trying to remember all the reasons.
You don't?
I feel good. I feel right. I feel like I'm on an illegal high, babe. Something's wrong here, certainly. See, that's where I'll just start having fun and changing it, but it doesn't happen to me easily.
You,
I think I'd have to remember that.
You play with your voice. It's like playing, drink a cup of tea.
And just have fun.
Sing to you is like eat. It's like drink a glass of water.
Well, you know, though, now it's because I haven't sung. So it's like, I get to sing. Oh, I'm so excited. So it's I joke and say it's kind of like, yeah, it's like a kid with ice cream who hasn't had ice cream forever. It's like, oh, yay.
And you can sing for us, One of Us.
I'm trying to remember the verse. What if God was one of us? Just a slob like one of us. Just a stranger on the bus trying to make his way home. Trying to make his way back home.
Perfect.
I'm surprised to remember.
Good, there's a lot of time, but I know you will return to sing. We hope. I don't know. Nothing.
I hope we all return to a lot of
yes.
things. Live performance, live music. I mean, how do you find, how do you feel now? Do you miss live music? Do you miss live performance?
Miss events, miss stage, miss concert. There's a lot of miss. But yeah. we'll pass through this. We yeah. will see each other and play, and you can sing for us. And can you leave your social media, your app, website, where I can find Kimberly?
Well, I'm doing the slow update now. So you can find me on Facebook. I'm revamping my Facebook page. Because on Facebook, you can have a single page. And yeah, my webpage probably needs a good update with all of the current stuff that I've done.
But no, you're always so red for us. You always answer us.
I try. Sometimes I forget or I get busy, life. But I try. So now I'm getting hot. Looking at you, I'm getting hot.
I'm so happy.
Oh, I've lost you there.
Oh, God. But I want to.
Sorry, I lost you there. Sorry.
God. Perfect. I'm here.
We're good. We're good.
Good. And thank you for having me. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for your attention. And you can leave a message for the Brazilian fans.
I wish that everybody stays healthy, happy, and has a lot of COVID-free adventures. Thank you so much for giving me your time and your love.
Thank you, my dear. Can you sing a little bit for us with the same energy of Simple Wish that time? Faster, a little bit. Just a few seconds.
I feel good. I feel right. I feel like I'm on an illegal high. Something's wrong, certainly. This doesn't happen to me easily. My love, maybe so. I can't remember, but I don't know. 'Cause I go to bed with sinful wishes. Oh, I go to sleep. Yeah, I go to sleep with sinful wishes of you, babe.
Claps, 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 applause. Thank you, my dear. Thank you for giving me this chance and make this dream come true. Brasil loves you.
Thank you so much. Stay safe and healthy.
Então é isso. Se você gostou do conteúdo, deixa seu like, se inscreva no canal e compartilhe este conteúdo. Quer conferir outras entrevistas realizadas pelo Som do Cassete? Só você clicar aqui nessa playlist. E também te espero lá no clube de membros estribados do canal Som do Cassete, para você ter acesso antecipado a todo o conteúdo do Som do Cassete e, claro, também fazer perguntas para os entrevistados. Eu fico por aqui, até o próximo vídeo do canal O Som do Cassete.